Hello students, today let us discuss about Poisson distribution in module 3. In this module we have already discussed about what is discrete random variable and discrete probability distribution, continuous probability distribution, random variable and some basic definitions related to probability. So here in this session I'm going to talk about Poisson distribution. So what is Poisson distribution is? So Poisson distribution is a limiting case of binomial distribution. So you have already come across the binomial distribution. So you might have remembered the expression which looks like it is similar to P of x is equal to ncx p power x into q to the power of n minus x. And this Poisson distribution is a special case of binomial distribution. So in binomial distribution, that is in P of x is equal to ncx p to the power of x and q to the power of n minus x, if the, what is that limiting case is? So if n is too large, so if n value is too large, what is n here? N is number of trials. So if n is too large, that is if n tending to infinity and p is too small, what is p here is? P is number of success. Success is taken as P and Q was the failure. So P is too small. The success rate of an event which you get an required outcome is very less. So it is almost equal to 0. That is when P tending to 0, then the mean N into P, say M, or then N into P. So Q is almost, and since P is 0, so the expression gives, the expression becomes m to the power of x and e to the power of minus m divided by x factorial is called as the Poisson distribution, and where m is the mean here. So np was the mean for Poisson distribution, that itself we have taken it as m, and we have used that here in this expression. So p of x is equal to m power x and e to the power of minus m by x factorial is called as the Poisson distribution, and m here represents the mean. So remember, the binomial distribution and the Poisson distribution, the difference here is very small and it is a limiting case of binomial distribution. So Poisson distribution as a probability function. So every distribution has its probability function in a different way defined. So here also, what is that the probability function looks like for the Poisson distribution is. So take the random variable x and the probability function as p of x here. Give the values for x as 0, 1, 2, 3 and so on. And for each value of x, evaluate here p of x. What is the p of x expression? Just in the previous slide I told you. And there in that expression you have to substitute x is equal to 0. So if x is equal to 0, in the expression e to the power of minus m and whatever the expression we had, and we get the, it is as e to the power of minus m. And when x takes the value 1, then x takes the value 1, your Poisson distribution expression gives you the value m e to the power of minus m by m factorial. And similarly, when x takes the value 2, your p of x becomes m square e to the power of minus m by 2 factorial. And when x takes the value 3, p of x becomes m cube into e to the power of minus m by 3 factorial. Likewise, you can give the value for x, different values of x, and you can get the values of p of x accordingly. So once after doing this, you can observe the values of whatever the expressions that you had got for p of x, everywhere you can see the term e to the power of minus m. So which can be taken it out as a common term, and all the values of p of x, all the expressions whatever you had got for different values of x in the above table, add all those values of p of x and take out e to the power of minus m as a common term. So once we do that, we get e to the power of minus m, it is multiplied to 1 plus m by 1 factorial plus m square by 2 factorial plus and so on. And this 1 plus m by 1 factorial plus m square by 2 factorial plus m cube by 3 factorial plus and so on is an exponential series in m. So try to remember your exponential series e to the power of x. The exponential series of e to the power of x is 1 plus x by 1 factorial plus x square by 2 factorial plus x cube by 3 factorial plus and so on. So the same thing here, instead of x we have got m. So this is an exponential series in terms of m. So e to the power of minus m, which you have taken it out as a common term, is there as it is. And whatever is there in the bracket is an exponential series, which we can write it as e to the power of m. So now e to the power of minus m and e to the power of m, they are in the product. So we can add the powers of exponential terms. So we get the answer as e to the power of 0. So sum of all the terms of p of x, which is nothing but summation of p of x. And when we add, we had got the value as 1. So summation of p of x is equal to 1. So once we get sum of all the values of p of x is equal to 1, we can conclude that whatever the p of x we have considered as a probability function. So Poisson distribution as a probability function, it is satisfied, and p of x is a probability function here. So what is, I also told you in the previous sessions about the mean standard variation with respect to the different distributions. We have discussed about binomial distribution, and we have also discussed about discrete probability distribution and continuous probability distribution. So here with respect to Poisson distribution also, we need to discuss what is the mean standard deviation of a Poisson distribution S. So for a Poisson distribution, mean is M. You might have remembered in the first slide, we have taken M, N into P as M, and mean here is M, and variance is also M, and standard deviation is square root of M. So variance and standard deviations, the definition is same. Like variance and standard deviation is always a square root of variance. So mean here is M, variance here is M, and standard deviation is square root of M. So remember, the mean and variance is same for Poisson distribution. So let us consider few examples so that you can understand this concept in a better way. So first example, the probabilities of the Poisson variate taking the values 3 and 4 are equal. This is a given data, and it has been asked us to calculate the probabilities of variate taking the values 0 and 1. So understand the problem, probabilities of the Poisson variate x values taking the values 3 and 4 is same. It says it is the same, and calculate the probabilities of variate taking the values 0 and 1. We need to calculate when the variate, Poisson variate takes the value 0, what is that we get for a probability function, and what is probability function when x takes the value 1. So when we do that, we know from the Poisson distribution definition that p of x is m to the power of x and e to the power of minus m divided by x factorial that we have derived in the first slide itself. And given p of 3 and p of 4 is same, the Poisson variate is same, is equal. That means that p of 3 and p of 4 are same. That is why we have written it as p of 3 is equal to p of 4. So what is p of 3 is? In the above expression, replace x is equal to 3. So p of x is equal to m power x and e to the power of minus m by x factorial. And on replacing x is equal to 3, you get m cube e to the power of minus m by 3 factorial. And on replacing x is equal to 4, you get m to the power of 4 and e to the power of minus m by 4 factorial. So now, m cube and m to the power of 4 on both the sides, you can cancel m cube and e to the power of minus m also gets cancelled on both the sides. And remaining is 3 factorial is nothing but 6, and 4 factorial is nothing but 24. So remaining is m divided by 24 is equal to 1 by 6, and which gives us the value as m is equal to 4. So p of x is, now you can substitute m is equal to 4 in the definition of Poisson distribution, that is p of x. So p of x is equal to 4 to the power of x and e to the power of minus 4 by x factorial. So now this is our probability function, and for this function we need to calculate when x is equal to 0 and when x is equal to 1, what is that it gives. So now just replace x is equal to 0 in your expression. So you get p of 0 is equal to 4 to the power of 0 and e to the power of minus 4 by 0 factorial. 0 factorial is nothing but 1, which we all know. And 4 to the power of 0 is also 1. So therefore we get the answer as e to the power of minus 4. In other words, it is 1 divided by e to the power of 4. Similarly, let us substitute x is equal to 1 in the expression. And we get it as p of 1 is equal to 4 power 1 e to the power of minus 4 by 1 factorial. And 4 to the power of 1 is 4 and 1 factorial is 1. So we get the answer p of 1 is equal to 4 divided by e to the power of 4. So given was p of 3 and p of 4 was same, and it was asked us to evaluate what is p of 0 and p of 1, and we have evaluated the both. So problem is very simple here. And let us move on to the second example, which is similar to the previous one, and we can understand the concept in a better way if you work out different types of problems. So here the statement of the problem is the probability that the news reader commits no mistake in reading the news is 1 divided by e to the power of 3. Find the Poisson variate and newspaper having only 2 mistakes. In the second case is more than 3 mistakes. In the third case is at most 3 mistakes. So understand the statement here. Probability that the news reader commits no mistake in regarding the news is 1 divided by e to the power of 3. Find the Poisson variate. Find the Poisson variate and newspaper having only 2 mistakes when x is equal to 2 and more than 3. So when x is more than 3 and at most 3. So at most 3 is maximum 3. So what we need to find out all those things in this example especially. So let us move on to the solution. So solution, consider your Poisson distribution expression which is p of x is equal to m to the power of x and e to the power of minus m divided by x factorial. So given that news reader commits no mistake is 1 divided by e to the power of 3. Let us call this as equation 1. If the news reader commits no mistake, then x is equal to 0. Means the Poisson variate x, no mistake. So x takes the value 0. No, here is nothing but nil. So p of x is equal to 0. Just replace x is equal to 0. You get it as m to the power of 0. e to the power of minus m by 0 factorial, which gives us e to the power of minus m. So take this as equation 2 and keep it aside. And now combining equation 1 and 2. So newspaper, the news reader commits no mistake is given by 1 by e to the power of 3. And when we had given no mistakes as an x is equal to 0 value, we had got e to the power of minus m. So on solving equation 1 and 2, we observe that e to the power of minus 3 is equal to e to the power of minus m. And hence the value of m is equal to 3. Just on comparing on both the sides, we can conclude that the value of m is here is equal to 3. So from the Poisson distribution now, just replace m is equal to 3 and rewrite your Poisson distribution expression, which gives you 3 p of x is equal to 3 power x e to the power of minus 3 and divided by x factorial. So let us consider the first sub-equation here. What is the sub-equation? Only 2 mistakes happens. So only 2 mistakes. It means that the value of x is equal to 2. So p of 2 is equal to 3 to the power of 2 e to the power of minus 3 by 2 factorial. When we evaluate this, p of 2 gives us the value as 0.22404. Second sub-question was more than 3 mistakes. The value of x is greater than 3. So value of x is greater than 3 means it can take the value 4, it can be 5, it can be 10, it can be 50, it can be 100, and it can go up to infinity. So instead of evaluating all those values individually, what we can do is we can consider, because any probability value is 1, and if we subtract p of x less than or equal to 3 from 1, whatever the answer we get, it will be the answer for p of x greater than 3. So try to understand this. P of x can be written as 1 minus p of x less than or equal to the previous number. So here p of x greater than 3 can be written as 1 minus p of x less than or equal to 3. So keep that one as it is, minus p of x less than or equal to 3, less than 3 and also equal to 3. So what are all the values we get? We get p of 0, p of 1, p of 2 and p of 3. So addition of all those. So now 1 minus p of 0. So substitute x is equal to 0 in your previous expression. We get it as e to the power of minus 3 and n to the power of 0 by 0 factorial plus when p is when x is equal to 1, you get e to the power of minus 3 into 3 to the power of 1 by 1 factorial. And when x is equal to 2, you get e to the power of minus 3 into 3 to the power of 2 by 2 factorial and so on. So e to the power of minus 3 is a common term, so you can take it out. E to the power of minus 3 into 3 power 0 by 0 factorial plus 3 by 1 factorial plus 3 by 2 factorial plus 3 to the power of 3 by 3 factorial. When we evaluate all this, and we get the answer as p of x greater than or equal, greater than 3 is 0.3528 when x is greater than 3. That is when more than 3 mistakes which happens in the news reading part. So, and moving on to the third sub-question, which is at most 3 mistakes. at most. It means that the maximum number of mistakes can happen as only 3. It cannot be more than that. So we can write that as P of x less than or equal to 3. X should be less than, means the number of mistakes should be less than 3. It cannot be more than 3. Less than or equal to 3. It can be equal to 3 also. So it is written as P of x less than or equal to 3. So what are all the values which comes less than or equal to 3 are P of 0, P of 1, P of 2, P of 3. Sum of all these things. So when we, this part we have just evaluated in the previous sub-question also. And when we simplify this, we get the answer as 0.6472. So this is about your third sub-question. So hope you understood this. And move on to the next example. Example 3. Number of accidents in a year for the taxi drivers in a city follows the Poisson distribution with mean is 3. Out of 1000 taxi drivers, find the approximate number of taxi drivers with no accidents in a year, more than 3 accidents in a year. So number of accidents in a year for the taxi drivers in a city follows the Poisson distribution. The number of accidents whichever happens in the city is being linked to a Poisson distribution, and we are trying to correlate the data with that here with the mean value as 3. So there is one particular statistics has been given for you in the problem. Out of 1000 taxi drivers, the maximum accidents has been taken here as 1000 taxi drivers, find the approximate number of taxi drivers with no accidents. It means when x is equal to 0, more than 3 accidents in a year. Second sub question is when more than 3 accidents. So x is greater than 3. So this is about the problem. So solution here is, as it is, the first step is remains the same. Consider your Poisson distribution, which is P of x is equal to m power x and e to the power of minus m by x factorial. And mean is given as 3, and that is m is equal to 3. And substituting m is equal to 3 in the main definition, we get P of x is equal to 3 power x e to the power of minus 3 divided by x factorial. For 1000 taxi drivers, that is f of x is equal to 1000 into P of x. So f of x is equal to 1000 into P of x is nothing but e to the power of minus 3, 3 power x by x factorial. So on simplifying this, we get 3 to the power of x by x factorial, and e to the power of minus 3 divided by 1000 gives you the answer as 50. You can evaluate and check it out also. So we cannot go further simplification as x has been not specified clearly. So now we can keep this as a reference and we can move for the sub questions. So sub question is no accidents means x value is 0. F of 0 need to be evaluated now. So f of 0 is 50 into 3 to the power of 0 by 0 factorial, which gives the answer as 50. And the second sub question was more than 3 accidents means x is greater than 3. So as I said in the previous problem, greater than 3 can be 4, can be 10, can be 50, can be 100, and it can go up to infinity. So instead of evaluating those many values, and we doesn't even know like what is infinity is, so we can write that as 1 minus P of x less than or equal to 3. So using this, we can write P of x less than or equal to 3 will have P of 0, P of 1, P of 2, and P of 3, sum of all these things. And substitute 0, 1, 2, 3 in the previous expression of P of x and get your expressions. And on simplifying, we get the answer for P of x greater than 3 as 0.35. So we need to evaluate this for 1000 taxi drivers. Therefore, 1000 into 0.35 is 350. So this is what is the evaluation part that we can do it for this particular problem. So this is about the problems. Different problems has been solved, and more problems you can find it out in your notes also. For any clarification, get back to us through comments. Thank you.